oh, hey, we're on Saint Evans. All you heard me was saying was I need glasses. So I could think of like thousands of worse things we said on Sports Fan. Hey, welcome back to StAlbertSportsFan.com. I say welcome back. This is the second game of a doubleheader at the Mid-America Center for the Saints and Falcons. Saints dropped a 69-61 hard-fought game, high-scoring game, relatively speaking, to the Glenwood Rams. And now the boys, the Falcons, are going to play the Rams. Scott has done a little homework on these teams. He's going to tell us about it.
You tell you what, I was just kind of looking at some season stats for the Falcons. And, you know, the 3-8 record, I'm looking at some of the just a couple notes I made is with their shooting percentages. You know, the Falcons are only shooting 36% from the field, 27% from three-point line, and 52% from the free throw line. So that kind of tells the story of some low-scoring games and not being able to get the ball in the basket. But then I turned around and looked at Glenwood's season stats. Field goal-wise, they're at 46%. That's 10% more than the Falcons. But three-point percentage-wise, they're 27% also. And their free throw percentage is only 58%. So, I mean, you know, a lot of things about these teams are pretty close. Glenwood's going to come at you with a three-headed monster of scorers, and then it drops off drastically after that. Stanislav averaging 24.5 points a game. Blum is averaging 16, almost 17 points a game. And Carr is averaging 14.5 a game. So if we can do a job of trying to get a stop on at least one of them and make them work a little bit harder, I think that'd be a kind of the defensive philosophy a little bit for the Falcons.
We'll catch the starting lineups we can give you here. Falcons go this way. Sam Rollis, Ryan Hughes, Lance Wright, along with seniors Jared Gast and Reed Miller. The Glenwood Rams go this way. Junior Zach Carr, senior Ryan Leith, junior Dax, senior Dax Lapala, along with Christian Stanislav, also a senior, and sophomore Ryan Blum. Scott highlighted for you that Blum, Stanislav, and Carr, between them score the extreme lion's share of the points for the Rams. Experienced officiating crew, Barney Bob Johnson, Randy Baxter, and is that Jay Seeley?
Looks to be, yes.
He used to be the boys coach at Abraham Lincoln. Guys know the way around basketball. Yeah, I like what they do at the Mid-America Center here. They get a lot of good officials in. They match up the teams pretty well. It's a great environment. Thanks to the folks at Jenny Ed Sports Med and the Mid-America Center for inviting and having us up here to broadcast the game. So we're about to play some basketball. Stanislav to jump center against Jared Gast. Get the boys' names in mind now.
Yes.
Been talking about the girls, and rightly so. Ball goes to Rollis. Gets it to Hughes. He goes to the rim right away. Gets blocked. Can't score. Rams come the other way in a hurry. Rams cover a lot of ground with the pass. They move the ball quickly up and down the floor of the pass. The floor's a little longer. That's going to make it even potentially more of an advantage for them. Stanislav with a rebound and put back in the lane. Won't go. Scrum for the ball. Another rebound for the Rams. Stanislav turn around.
Keep giving him chances. He's going to finally convert there.
First two of the game. 31 seconds in. Christian Stanislav, I called him Andy. I think there was an Andy who's a brother who played before. And that was a kid from Woodbine, I'm thinking of. Christian, I apologize for using your last.
Looks like Glenwood's going to pick up the Falcons in man, and the post-entry pass there is stolen by Carr. He goes to the rim, misses.
Rams put it in again. That ball's going to pass basketball by Lapla, and Coach Ben Holling says, okay, there have been about six offensive rebounds in 53 seconds of basketball. I'm going to call a timeout and talk to my Falcons as they trail 4-0 here early in the game. Falcons have yet to get off a shot. Ball stolen at the other end. Boys had a tough game the other night. Go ahead, Scott.
Yeah, quick timeout there by Coach Holling. Just had a little something he wanted to tell him, probably a little bit more of a motivational talk than a lot of X's and O's there. Just, you know, rebounding is a lot about the want and the effort. And if you're not putting that forth, you're not going to be successful there. Glenwood's going to pick him up in a full court pressure there. Falcons do an easy job of getting it across.
Reed Miller's going to attempt a three off that, misses. Rebound by Gast. He goes back up off glass and scores. So the talk apparently had an effect. 4-2, Rams lead here. 6:49 to go in the first quarter, so just a minute in. Falcons playing man-to-man. Lance Wright guarding Carr. Ball goes in the corner. Three-pointer attempt is missed that time by Leith. Reed Miller Kidd with the nose for the ball. Gets the rebound. Hughes to run the offense for the Falcons. Hughes, Rollis, Gast, Wright, and Miller on the floor for the Falcons. Gast looks at a three, drives to the elbow. Jump stop. Can't get it to go off glass. Rebound coming the other way is Stanislav. Between a leg dribble, gets to the rim and scores. He has four. The 6-2 Rams lead. 2 minutes into the game. Ball goes in the corner to Rollis. Nice pass from Rollis into Reed. Miller scores with the left hand. Nice assist by Sam, sophomore to senior. It's 6-4. The Falcons have settled in a little bit here after getting pounded on the boards a little bit early.
Falcons coming at Glenwood with their man-to-man defense.
Leith drives a three from the corner and gets it to go. Ryan Leith, senior, averages 4 points, four rebounds. Drills that from the left side. 9-4 Rams.
Every time you say that name, Matt, I'm thinking Ryan Leaf.
A three-pointer miss that time by Gast. I think of Leith and Leach mm-hmm. and Leith, games, names like that. A lot of those are start in Scotland. There's a reach in, unnecessary foul made by one of the Rams. Just a reach around by, I think that was Leith. Early substitution in the game for the Falcons is junior Jack Eicholt, number 32. And that foul on the Rams, that on Leith, I think it was.
Ryan Hughes sitting down, bringing the point guard duties to junior Lance Wright.
Yeah, you know that kid. We both know that kid. You better than most. There's a backdoor pass partly knocked away by Leith. Coming the other way with a basketball. Gets it to Stanislav. Oh, blocked from behind by Eicholt, but fouled underneath by Wright, so it appears. Two free throws coming.
They're going to give Rollis the foul there.
Okay. Christian Stanislav at the line to shoot two free throws. He has four at this point. First free throw, back iron, no good.
We went over this pregame. My surprising stat of the day is I went and looked through things that Stanislav's only shooting 44% from the free throw line. He gets there quite often.
Yeah. I think a guy that scores 24.5 a game, you expect a higher number, percentage-wise anyway. Gets the second one to go, has five. Falcons working against a full-court Ram pressure. Eicholt with it, back to Wright. Wright needs to get that across the line, just does. Keeps the dribble, hands off to Eicholt.
Plenty of time with no shot clock in high school here.
Yes.
Let's get a nice set. Eicholt's going to drive baseline into.
It's going to be fouled.
They're going to call hold out front on that by on number five, Carr for Glenwood. It's going to be their first team foul. Brings an inbounds play. Lance Wright will inbound the ball for the Falcons. Ball into Reed Miller. Miller's going to attempt a three, hits off the front of the rim, rebound goes to Glenwood. Thing we noticed the first time we played these guys is how quick they converted from defense to offense. We'll see how that plays out on this bigger court here tonight.
Hey, I think it should give them more of a chance, more space to use that speed of conversion. 10-4, you probably mentioned that. This is not a
it's CB. All right, good buddy.
Yeah, it's not a CB radio thing. I've never owned a Citizens Band radio in my life. I might get that engraved on my tombstone. Proud of that fact. There's a basket by Stanislav, and he's fouled. I have a free throw coming.
Stanislav there just kind of picks the ball up that's rolling through the lane that had bounced off someone's leg and then turn throws it up and gets fouled. So going to give the Rams a chance for a three-point play.
Did not see who that foul went on and missed that there. Free throws missed. Reed Miller with another rebound. Ball goes to Gast. Tries to wheel into the lane. Left hand, jump stop shot. Good. Nice little ball fake and basket by Gast. He has four of the six for the Falcons. It's a 12-6 Rams advantage. Blum misses a shot. Lance Wright rebounds. Looks to push, but the Rams are back. Lance gets to the rim, though. Gets it. Oh, in and out off glass. Rollis can't get it to go. Might have been hacked. Reed Miller comes up with it, and he's going to be fouled from below that time by Leith. His second. A couple of new Rams checking in. We'll get their numbers. A little hard to make out their.
Yes, both numbers. These teams with the not solid numbers.
Yeah.
Just the just the piping outline of the numbers.
Cade Van Ness is one of the guys who checks in for the Rams. There's a three-point attempt by Lance Wright. Good. Drains the three. It's a 12-9 game.
Falcons make a nice little run to kind of get back in this game. It was an eight-point game there.
Shot good. That's Stanislav. Yeah, fading away in the corner for three. Has 10 already.
He's definitely a scorer. Probably one of the better scorers in the state of Iowa in Class 3A.
It'd have to be. As most folks know, Glenwood coming off a 3A state championship season last year. Lance Wright's going to try another three. That one, back iron, no good. Poked out by Rollis. It'll stay with the Rams or go to the Rams. 15-9. Lead for the Rams. Falcons are going to pick up near half court. Lance Wright going to work against Van Ness, I think, with the ball. No, that's, Carr. Rams right now working around the perimeter, looking to get something probably to go toward the basket.
Looks like we're kind of face guarding, trying to keep the ball out of Carr's hands here with Wright.
Jack Hughes checks in. He's working with the ball at the top of the key. And the drive, Van Ness, a stop. Misses a shot. And there's a rebounding foul going to go on Stanislav. His first. Checking in is Jeff Miller for the Falcons, and Lance Wright's going to take a seat. Jeff Miller, Reed Miller, Jared Gass, Jack Eicholt, and Sam Rollis on the floor for the Falcons. Trailing by half a dozen, they have the ball. 2 minutes to go in the first quarter.
Rollis with the ball on the wing.
The three-point attempt by Eicholt gets it to go. Jack Eicholt, his first points of the night. It's a 15-12. Lead for the Rams. Falcons within three. You said before the game, Scott, Falcons just need to hit some shots. So they're able to do that. Nice rebound on the other end by Eicholt. Brings the ball up, trailing the pack. Goes corner to Rollis. He's going to try a three from the right side. Can't get it to go. Pushing all the Rams the other way. Hughes, a little jump stop. Van Ness is open on the wing. Nobody guards Cade Van Ness. Averages 3 points a game and now has two.
5 point ball game coming up on a minute here. Reed Miller with a quick three. Nice rebound by Gast. He goes up. Yep. They do not call the foul there.
Yeah, blocked that time by Blum. Looked like a decent block from here. 1 minute to go. Falcons trail by five. The Rams have the ball. Stepping into a three, missing the Rams. There's going to be a foul on the floor. One of the Falcons, perhaps Gast, picks up the rebounding foul. Or maybe Reed Miller. That is Gast. 34.
And Coach Holland's going to just go grab Jared here real quick, not try to pick up another foul on defense here. Brings Connor Cherney into the game. Imagine this might be a defense to offense substitution.
Yeah. Rams get a nice inbound play and heading toward the basket and laying it in is Carr. His first two, and it's a 19-12. Rams lead, 45 seconds to go in the quarter. Cherney's going to try a three. Can't get it to go. Rebound by Carr, coming the other way. Carr weaves his way inside, but coming up with the ball is Cherney. Dribbles out of some pressure. Gets it to Miller, Jeff Miller.
Plenty of time on the clock here.
Eicholt's going to try a little three floater, doesn't get it to go. Rebound for the Rams is Van Ness. 16 seconds to go. Rams are going to go for the one shot.
Falcons need to gather themselves up here defensively a little bit. Getting a little loose here.
Yeah. Do need to stop. Carr's jumper from near the free throw line missed. Cherney with the rebound. That's going to end the quarter, 19-12. The Rams lead the Falcons. I'm going to talk about one of our sponsors. I bet Spencer's going to hand me a page to tell me who that is. And we are going to talk about Kelly's Carpet Furniture of Council Bluffs. Oh, I love to talk about them. Long-standing supporter of St. Albert Schools and a friend of St. Albert Sports Fan. This game is brought to you by Jan Hughes and everyone here at Kelly's Carpet and Furniture of Council Bluffs. See some of Jan's kids and grandkids from right here as we speak. So whether it's carpet, hardwood, area rugs, tile, stone, luxury vinyl, plank, laminate, or Kelly's Carpet and Furniture of Council Bluffs is the last number you need to know when you have a need for your floors. They will provide a free in-home estimate, and they will work with you on interior design ideas and even offer different financing options. Be sure to contact Kelly's Carpet and Furniture of Council Bluffs for all your flooring needs. And when you see Jan, tell her hi from her friends at StAlbertSportsFan.com. ...19-12 as we start the second quarter. Rams leading the Falcons. No surprise, Christian Stanislav averages 24.5 points per game, has 10. Falcons 12, pretty balanced. Four for Gass, three-piece for Wright and Eicholt. Miller with a basket. Rams with the ball to start the second quarter. Up by that 7 points we talked about. Stanislav inside, positions himself. Ball nearly stuck on the rim. Comes away, Stanislav gets the rebound. Swung over, Hughes is going to get in the lane. He's going to be blocked from behind is Jack Hughes. He'll have two free throws coming.
Falcons start the quarter off with Wright, Rawless, Cherney, Jeff Miller, and Jared Gast on the floor.
Not sure who picked up that foul for the Falcons. Yeah, four team fouls at any rate.
Connor Cherney with
the
foul there.
Now we have that down. First free throw is good, and second good as well for Hughes.
Nine-point ball game here.
Six-foot senior Jack Hughes converts both free throws.
Falcons can't let this get slipping away too much more here. Need to have a solid offensive possession.
Jeff Miller gets the post.
Nice post feed. Tough shot by Gass there. Nobody on the backside to corral that rebound.
30 seconds gone in the quarter. First 2 points have gone to the Rams. Three-point attempt stepped into and drained that time by Dax Lapala. He now has five, and it's a doubled-up lead, 24-12. Right with a basketball on the left side. Gass is going to put up a three. Can't get it to go. Rebound by Rawless. His turnaround put back is good. Cherney kept the ball alive, and Rawless picked it up and scored his first two, averages 10 a game, 24-14.
Falcons are switching up their defense here a little bit. Got a caught in a little confusion, but three-point basket's missed in the corner.
And that rebound went to Blum. He's yet to score, a little bit of a surprise. Blum kicks it on the deep right side, and the shot is good that time by, is that Hughes? Jack Hughes now has five after he made a free throw and hit that three at the other end. Shot by Cherney is blocked. Coming the other way are the Rams. There's going to be a foul on the floor that time. So it'll be Rams ball underneath.
I'm going to call that on Rawless, and if I have my numbers right, I believe that's Sam's second foul.
It is his second, fifth on the team.
Eichel, Hughes, and Reed Miller check into the game. They're in along with Gast and Wright.
Carr gets it over to Leith. Ball poked away by Ryan Hughes. A scrum for the ball. Hughes comes up with it, flips it to Reed Miller, gets it ahead to Jeff, to Eicholt. Can't quite control it. He's going to step out and take a three. Instead, doesn't go. Reed Miller rebounds. He's going to be fouled that time by Blum, I believe. Yeah, Reed Miller did a nice job. Reed did a nice job getting the ball ahead. But Eicholt couldn't quite control it after that.
Just kind of fumbled off his hands a little bit there. Was able to regather it and keep the offensive possession for the Falcons.
He's good at shooting threes, able to get one off, and then Reed Miller wisely got in to rebound that. 27-14, though. Falcons trail nearly doubled up. Ryan Hughes with the basketball. Working out top. Rams playing some man-to-man. Falcons not able to advance it because through the dribble. Wright's going to work off a screen by and miss the three. Nice screen there by Gast.
Up high. Yeah. Yep.
Stanislav swings it over. And a three-point shot missed that time by Blum. But a shot, a foul on the rebound. Two free throws coming. Maybe Lance Wright on the foul?
Yes.
I look for the player who was walking away, shaking his head. And that's usually who the foul's on. That was Lance. Two free throws coming for Leith. Made a three-pointer so far.
I think it's Blum at the line.
Is it Blum?
Yep.
And first free throw misses. Blum still scoreless. That most likely to change. 6'3 sophomore misses the first attempt. 27-14. Second free throw is good. He has one now. Doubled up are the Falcons, 28-14, trailing by as many as they have. Drive by Eicholt, tries to get to the glass but stops. Gas turns down a three. Now Hughes with it near the elbow, cut off. Looks to get out to Reed Miller at the three-point line. Not much doing inside for the Falcons. Linwood doing a nice job. Wright regains the ball after it's poked. Reed Miller turns down a three. Shot in the lane by Miller, bounces around and just misses.
Not going to get the bounce that he wants off that.
No. Ball goes, Rams swing it in a hurry. Steal by Reed Miller, though. Nice job. The pass was intended for Blum, but Reed Miller intercepts it. Ryan Hughes is going to try a three. Can't get it to go. Eicholt tries to rebound and goes off his hands out of bounds to the Rams.
That previous three for the free throw there saw a nice little exchange by a couple of the better catchers in the Hawkeye 10 conference. Lance Wright and Cade Dennis changing pleasantries and a nice little laugh there.
Yeah. Guys that know what it's like to put on the equipment. Shot is missing the lane. Ryan Hughes going to track down the long rebound. Looks to push, but three Rams are back. Hughes hands it off to Eicholt. Swings it back to Hughes. Now to Wright. Looking to work off a Miller screen. He's going to try a three. Good.
That's his second of the game.
That's right. With a couple of those, he has six first half points. 28-17. Just under 4 minutes to go. Free throw line jumper drained that time. Blum now has three in the game. 30-17. Wright works off a Miller screen. There's a pass nearly stolen. Eicholt tries to get into the lane. Gets it to Miller. And it's going to be a jump ball. Yeah, Eicholt had a chance. He's being unselfish.
Yes.
Had a chance to try to put it up. And coach for the Falcons, Hollings, is going to substitute five new guys.
So looks like we have Cheryl, Rawless,
Cherney,
Jeff Miller, and Aiden Anastel.
Just going to give those guys a break. Probably thought they'd gone on a while. Shot missed inside by Rawless. That's normally his shot. Can't get it to go. Ball knocked, near knocked away by Rawls, but the Rams retained possession. Falcons weren't able to take it the other way. 3:10 to go until halftime. And steal by Rawls. Working, chasing, got one man chasing, tries to work it ahead, lays it off, a little too hard off the glass. And Rams coming the other direction. Jeff Miller back playing D, about the only one to beat the Rams down the floor. Van Ness with a little inside runner won't go. Rebound out to Jeff Miller. Cut off by the Rams and just does retain possession. Connor Cherney with it. Goes into the glass and scores.
Nice little finish there by Cherney. Had me a little nervous there. Thought he might have been a little bit out of control, but he went up nice and strong and player slid in underneath him. It's a good call.
Blum picks up his first foul and Cherney with a chance for a three-point play the way we used to know them. First two in the game for the sophomore. He cannot get it to go. 30-19.
Falcons need some stops here on defense. We talked about it in the girls game the last couple minutes of the half and need to keep this thing within reach here.
Ball again knocked away by Rawless. Anisdale saves it back into Rawless. He keeps his dribble, the left-hand sophomore. Cut off that time by Carr. And still with it, top of the key. Now back to Rawless. Working off a screen by Cherney. Jeff Miller and Estelle. Gets to the free throw line, swings it over to Jeff Miller. Miller tries to drive baseline, cut off. Cherney's going to try three from the left side. And Connor Cherney.
Connor
gets it to go. He has five now in the game. It's a 30-22 game. I should have said at the time, and I'm not saying it now because we scored a couple points, but sometimes you just need the guys on the floor are tired. You put in five new guys.
Yes.
And it was just a fatigue thing. You know, it's not – we'll start with these guys and change things up on the other team. It's like changing defenses. You just change lines if you're able to. Rams, though, keep pounding that offensive glass and get a score and a foul. Leith picks up those two. He now has five.
Minute 32 here. 10-point lead at the moment for the Rams.
17 foul on the Falcons. I didn't catch who that foul was on, but one of those five guys on the floor. Leith's free throw is no good, but the ball's poked back nearly in. They go to, in the basket, that is. They go back to the Falcons, however. Glenwood drops back into a half-court defense here at this point with a minute and a half to go. And still brings it across the half to Rollis. Turns down a Cheryl screen, gets to the glass, gets it to go.
Sam, nice move by Sam there. Falcons are going to pick him up full court here. Rollis' length creates some problems up there up front.
Just quick hands and long arms. Mm-hmm. 32-24. Rams, though, defeat that and get a layup from Bloom. He now has five. Oh, Lapla, excuse me. Lapla, he has seven. 10-point lead, 34-24. Falcons appear to be going with these five for the remainder of the half. And it still tries to drive baseline. It's cut off. Nearly stolen that time by Lapla, but Falcons retain the ball. There'll probably be a dance team performance of some sort at halftime, it looks like. We'll just turn off the camera. We'll talk about one of our sponsors as the half ends, but then we'll go right to the dance team after that. 10-point Falcon deficit. There's going to be a foul. That's going to go on Lapla. He got a hold of Jeff Miller. Don't think he was
shooting. Randy Baxter's going to call that on the floor. Yeah. I kind of thought he was coming up with it, but not necessarily shooting, but I've seen balls like that be called shooting fouls there. But now they are going to call it as a
one-on-one.
Well, we're in the bonus.
The bonus. Okay. So now for the last 45 seconds, Rollis is going to take a break, and Cy Patterson's going to check in the game. So kind of a switch out there for a couple of guys.
Jeff Miller misses the front end there of the one-on-one.
Misses that free throw.
10-point ball game. This feels like a Falcons needed to get a defensive stop here on this possession.
Rams potentially could go for the one. I think I saw someone hold up one finger. It's 25 seconds remain. Jack Hughes with it out.
Little token pressure up front. A little kind of a 1-3-1 look here by the Falcons with Connor Cherney up top.
Glenwood terrific at passing the ball and finding the angle, so they'll have to
bring it down sharp. They bring it down under 10 here. Yeah. Now they're going to look into the high post to Blum. And he flips it back out to Carr, who misses the three.
That will end the half as Cheryl fights that rebound. 34-24 is the score. Falcons outscored 17-12 that quarter. It's 34-24 halftime score. And we want to talk about the Glass Doctor, if that's all right, Spencer. I think I took him out of order, but we'll get to all our great fine sponsors. The Glass Doctor of Council Bluffs serves businesses, homes, and auto owners in Council Bluffs, Carter Lake, Neola, and the surrounding areas. It's a locally owned business, and they offer you affordable, quick glass services. Let our trusted glass professionals install, repair, replace, and renovate your glass products. Our team is dedicated to helping you achieve your desires, whether it's customizing your home glass decor, installing reflective glass at your office, or repairing and replacing your windshield. The professionals at the Glass Doctor, hey, they won't disappoint you. Call them today, 712-323-3112. Now you get to watch the St. Albert Dance Team.
In the distance is a house upon the hill. Behind the back of that house, a place where you'll be safe to feel our graces. We've all made mistakes. If you've lost your way, I'll leave it alone. Thank you.
stretch it ever again.
Give it up for the Glenwood Dance Team.
No, I didn't. Nobody gave me back.
Thank you.
All right, Spencer's going to play around with that thing. Let's talk about somebody before we start the half. Yes. Hey, let's talk about St. Albert Sports Fan for the latest news and information about all things St. Albert and, excuse me, sports and beyond. Be sure to check out stalbertsportsfan.com. Live game broadcasts, video archives, audio archives, photos, and more photos. Every St. Albert event chronicled, every St. Albert team covered, alumni information, fine arts, mass schedules, you name it, stalbertsportsfan.com has it. stalbertsportsfan.com, your one-stop shop for everything St. Albert. And don't forget to follow us on Twitter and Instagram. stalbertsportsfan is our handle. About to start the third quarter here. I can give you some quick scoring rundown and have Scott talk about what to look for. Leading scorer in the game at this point, no surprise for the Rams. Christian Stanislav has 10, 7 for Dax Lapla. There's a bit of a surprise, double his average. Blum has 3, 5 points for Jack Hughes, 5 points for Ryan Lee, 2 for Zach Carr, and Cade Van Ness with 2 off the bench for the Rams. Falcons scoring goes this way. Actually, Lance Wright, leading scorer, with 6, followed by 5 from Connor Cherney. Gass with 4, Eichholt with 3, Rouse with 4, and Reed Miller with 2. Those are the 24 for the Falcons. 34-24, Falcons trail this game, and the Rams will have the ball to start the third quarter.
Falcons need to come out and do a better job on the boards. It's kind of a thing for the season there, but they need to rebound here a little better and communicate a little bit better on defense here, switching off, not letting some open shots get off. Glenwood starts with the ball. Zach Carr up top with it.
It's kind of a 3-2 zone, or maybe it might morph into a 1-3-1, but three men across the top. So I've seen a lot more college teams doing that 3-2 this
3-2,
year.
3-2, the game's become so perimeter-oriented now
right.
that it's you don't pack the paint, you pack the three-point line.
Three-point shot is missed that time by the Rams, but they end up coming up with the rebound. A couple Falcons had it. And Gass with a steal. Gets it to Hughes. Hughes ahead to Lance Wright on the right side. He's going to step into a three on the move. In and out won't go. He's hit a couple of them here in the game. Just misses that one. Rams coming back the other way. Stanislav nails the elbow jumper. He has a dozen now in the game. It's a 36-24 lead for the Falcons. Deficit for the Falcons. We'll get that right. Wishful thinking at this point. Rouse is going to attempt a three. Back iron, no good. Rebound by Stanislav. Pushes it ahead. Rams stepping into a three. I think it's Blum. And gets it to go. It is Blum, called by the PA guy. He has, with that three, he has 6 in the game. 39-24. Hughes to Gass. Rams playing some man-to-man. Goes in the post to Reed Miller. He has it knocked away from behind. That's going to be a foul on Lapla, his second. Falcons will have it underneath. Hughes to trigger it in. Hughes gets it into Gass, but the Falcons turn it over. Coming away with it and missing the shot of Stanislav, and either Hughes or Wright will pick up that foul.
I think they'll call that one on Lance Wright.
Most people know this if you're listening to our fan, to our broadcast. I'm Matt Madsen, and this guy is Scott Wright, dad of Lance, so there you go. I tell people all the time that no one's going to break my record of broadcasting their own kids' games. It just can't happen. But I'd like to live that long. That just means I'm old. Been around doing lots of games. A lot of baseball games. We did more back in the day. You have to talk to Spencer Scott about broadcasting some Falcons baseball games this summer. Been a couple of years, so maybe that can be some of the changes implemented with the change of ownership. Falcons trail by 15. Lance Wright's going to try a three from the corner. Can't get that to go, but Rallis rebounds it, and he comes up kind of gimpy on his ankle. And Reed Miller comes up with a steal back, coming the other way. A little scoop to Gast. He's blocked from behind. It'll stay with the Falcons. Let's see if Rouse has kind of walked off that gimpy ankle, but he's not wanting the coach to notice him. He wants to stay in the game. First, the only points of the half so far are a three-pointer for the Rams for Blum. Lance Wright's going to try a three. Looks good from here. Misses it offline a little bit. Blum rebounds. Pushes the other way. Three-pointer attempt is miss finally dropped out by Carr. Looked like it was going to go back in. A lot of backspin on that. Ryan Hughes gets to Rollis near the post. He's doubled but swings it to Lance Wright. And he's going to step into another three. Cannot get it to go. Those are the open shots. We have to take them. Reed Miller fights his way back inside. Can't get it to go. That's going to be a rebounding foul on Rollis.
I'm going to call that on Rollis. I think that'll be his third.
Sam's going to pick up three fouls. He has four in the game. Five minutes to go in the third quarter. 39-24. Falcons trail by 15 to Glenwood Rams. And I also can't tell you if this game counts in the Hawkeye 10 conference standings or not.
I want to say I think the first one did.
First one did.
I think our conference record was 2-3.
Okay.
And I think one of those wins didn't obviously count. I'm going to guess it was probably that first Red Oak game since we have Red Oak again on the schedule here.
As usual, insightful analysis from Scott figuring out how that works. I say I don't care, but he has it figured out. So
I figured you were the one that had it figured out. I just started thinking in my head.
This conference thing, I just decided I don't want to learn it because it doesn't make any sense to me. So Stanislav tries a three and drains it from top of the key. Stanislav now has 15 in the game.
Some scuttlebutt in the news this week about maybe a new member in the Hawkeye 10. The trainer Cardinals might put their application in. They're still kind of discussing that. And from what I read, they would have to give their conference a year notice. So if they were to join, it would not be until the 2021 seasons of athletics. So
sitting here from our perspective makes a lot of sense. I think it makes sense. It's easy for me to say, but to speak for another district, but makes sense to them and probably makes sense for the conference to accept that application. So just my one person's opinion.
I would not disagree with you, Matt.
To make the Hawkeye 10 stronger. It's not very good for the necessarily for the Western Iowa Conference, but Rollis gets that shot just rolls off the rim, and I think Eichel gets poked in the eye, but nonetheless, Rams coming the other way. Bloom gets to the glass. His left-handed roll shot drops around and in. Bloom now has 8 points. He had three at the half. It's 44-24. All of a sudden, the Falcons are down by 10. And coach is going to go for a new five-man miss. And Wright gets the basket. That gives Lance eight in the game. Leading Falcons scorer. 44-26. Stanislav for the free throw line jumper. Just misses. Scrum underneath. It's going to
go to the Falcons. Glenwood coach does not agree with that. He felt that was off of the Falcons. He's going to have kind of a wholesale substitution here. We got four boys checking in. We'll see who stays on the floor.
I think Eicholt's going to stay on the floor. Well, it's Eicholt, Cherney, Cheryl, Anistel, and Patterson. Your five for St. Albert. Trailing by 18 with 3.5 to go in the third quarter. This didn't work out too badly when the Falcons did this toward the end of the second quarter. Some new blood, and I guess some guys might be less fatigued. Anistel drives to the lane.
Nice
left-hand
move by Aiden
scores.
He's got such a tremendous quick first step there, and him being left-handed, he got to the rim easily on that side of the floor.
Coach is calling for a little bit different kind of defense on the press.
Somebody didn't do their rotation job back on that press there to cover that backside. Yeah.
I think that was Stanislav on the basket. I'll give him credit. Patterson gets to the free throw line, dishes to Cherney. He gets in the lane, gets bumped a little bit, goes up with a left hand, can't get it to go. Avoids a rebounding foul, but here come the Rams leading by 18. Stanislav left open from three-point line, can't get it to go. Crashing for the rebound is Cherney, but Stanislav gets it back, can't score. Gets it again. Series of moves, tries a fadeaway shot, no good. Rebound by Eicholt. Runs into some traffic, but gets out. Eichel cut off, gets into the lane, the jump stop. Anisdell tries to get to the rim again. Can't get it to go off glass, and rebound by Van Ness. Not much of a change in score lately. Still 48-26, 2 minutes thereabouts to go in the third quarter. Scott and Matt with you on SanAlbertSportsFan.com. Spencer and Sawyer running the computer and the scoreboard. Letting him play a little bit inside. There's Patterson ahead of the crowd, being chased by one man. But double dribble called on Cy Patterson. Just the hustle play just got ahead of him, that's all.
Even when the Falcons have had clean looks at the rim, we've just kind of stumbled, bumbled, and fumbled through there. Kind of looks a little bit like a folly video.
Yeah. Ooh, a folly. I haven't thought about those. NFL films used to be great. They don't kind of do those so much anymore, do they?
You could hear the boinks and the doings.
I suppose YouTube is taking care of that. Like, they don't need it anymore. People have to turn their television to see that kind of thing. Nice interior passing by Glenwood leads to a score by Stanislav. Christian Stanislav, I have him for 19, and the Rams lead by 20. Eicholt's going to try a three at the other end for the Falcons. Rims around, no good. Cherney battles for the rebound, but Jack Hughes comes away with it for the Rams. Hughes dishes it off to Bloom. He's left alone from the three. People leave away from him, so he gets the rebound, and Cherney fighting for the rebound gets fouled. The foul's going to go on Van Ness, I believe. Still, Van Ness is asking to whoever will listen or look at him why that was a foul. Minute 10 to go in the third quarter. 20-point Rams lead. Eicholt runs into a stop. Tries to get it to Reed Miller, but the ball's stolen away by Van Ness. Patterson with it for the Falcons instead. Anisdell tries to get to the lane. Left-handed scoop shot. Good. A couple times now. Aiden's got to the rim. He has 4 points. 48-30. Rams again slicing up that press. They're just so good and quick with the handle of the ball. But they miss the shot, get their rebound, but two more free throws coming for Stanislav. I think Connor Cherney is going to pick up that foul. That will be Connor's foul.
That's his second in the game. Yeah. I think I just heard the PA
answer say. Yeah, I did that too. Probably foul trouble not going to be an issue at this point.
Stanislav misses the first.
I looked away. My books, I'm glad you said that.
Going to have a couple new Falcons check into the game here. Ryan Ginneroux and Sam Narmi will check in for Cy Patterson and Jack Eicholt.
So now
that has emptied the bench for the Falcons at this point.
Free throw is good by Stanislav, second one. I have him for 20 points. And it's dealt with the ball.
Part of playing in an environment like this is trying to get your kids, everybody, a chance to get into the game and have some fun with this. And
Coach doing that early. It's a pretty substantial lead for the Rams here. 22 seconds to go in the quarter. Ryan Ginneroux dishes it off to Reed Miller. Reed Miller looking for an open guy. Gets it to Anisdell. 15 seconds to go in the quarter. A lot of dribbling by Anisdell. He finds a man in the corner. Ginneroux was open for three, but has a runner. Can't get it to go. But
nice
in.
Tip there by Connor Cherney.
Cherney working hard on the glass. Shot at the end of the quarter. He bounces off and misses that time for Carr. So at the end of three quarters of basketball, 49-32. We get Cherney's 2 points in here. I have him for seven. And I'm going to get a read here in just a second. And all right. We're going to talk about Southwest Orthodontics. They are your hometown orthodontist. My apologies. They create beautiful smiles. Southwest Orthodontics offers convenient 7 a.m. before school appointments. Visit one of Southwest Orthodontics' 8 area locations providing care for kids, teenagers, and adults. Learn more today at sworth.net.
Spent plenty of time there myself, Matt, with the kids. They do a tremendous job, a very nice office, and they really do work around the kids, trying not to get them to miss too much school. And
yes, we had we split a pair. One with the braces and the other did not require. Doing some quick math here.
Looks like the Falcons will counter with their starters back on the floor. So we have Wright, Reed Miller, Jared Gast, Sam Rollis, and Ryan Hughes. It's going to be the Falcons' ball. Down by 17.
The wholesale substitutions bringing in a new wave has really kind of worked pretty effectively for the Falcons. Really, I liken it to maybe you're just changing defenses. But you just kind of change out the guys. Rollis gets the ball in the post, but he's stopped up right away. Hughes gets to the elbow. He's going to kick it over to Reed Miller. Reed's going to try a three from the left side.
And drill it.
Rattles it in.
That was very nice ball movement by the Falcons on that possession there. A little bit more of a purpose, a little bit more of share in the basketball there, and results in an open three-point shot for Reed Miller.
Rams working it around their perimeter. LaPala has it knocked away by Ryan Hughes.
This game's sitting at 14 points at the moment. It's not out of reach. It starts on the defensive side of the ball here with getting some stops and converting it into some quick, efficient offense.
Rams have to inbound it from a pretty tough spot down there in the corner. You rarely see an inbound from that particular spot. But Rams get it in, no problem. But now a steal away by Rollis, working down the left side of the floor. Has it poked away from him, gets it back. Gets into Hughes. He tries to step through and go up with it. And he's going to be tied up.
Again, some just missed opportunities by the Falcons at the rim tonight. That's about the third play I can think of that just they could have had points at the rim. And
you put
that 6 points on the board, and you're talking about an eight-point ball game at the moment. So.
Yeah, we've got ahead of the crowd but couldn't quite finish it off. 49-35, Rams coming the other way. Bank shot good off glass. Well, that's what most bank shots are by Ryan Lee. He has seven. It's 51-35. Wright's going to try a long three rebound. It misses it. Rams come up with it the other way. Push it ahead. There's Stanislav ahead for the flush. That's 22. Missed shot, long rebound. Rams push it ahead. 53-35. The score is reversed, but Rams on the Falcons on the wrong end of that. Ahead with the ball and laying up his car. He has 4 points now, and it's a 20-point bulge all of a sudden, 55-35. Just down to 12 a second ago.
Just how quickly things change.
Yeah.
You know, it's a quick shot on offense probably by Wright there in that one possession, led to a long rebound out to a fast break. And
Ryan Hughes with the drive. He's going to be fouled on the floor. That foul is going to go on Dax LaPala. Should be his third. The offense will be inbounding it. Aiden Anistel checks in the game for Ryan Hughes. Anistel plays some nice minutes in the third quarter there, getting a couple of baskets, getting to the rim. Coach perhaps looking for some of that. Anistel top of the key. Gets in the post to Reed Miller. He's back out to Rollis. His three from the left side, no good, but Gass with the rebound. Gass with a little hook shot with the left, can't get it to go, but he is fouled, and two free throws coming. The foul's going to go on Leith. Again, foul problems, not an issue. 15 foul on the Rams, two for Gast.
It's kind of the first touch in a while I've seen on the offensive side for Gast as I sit
just
back and think about it. It's been kind of a quiet game for him, you know. Glenn Wood's got a couple nice bigs, couple physical guys.
Reed Miller's going to check out. Turney checks in. Turney, Gast, Rollis, Wright, and Anistel. Two free throws good for Jared Gast, so makes the most of that touch, draining those two.
Falcons pick up at full court and are going to get a turnover off of it here.
Nearly a live ball turnover. Falcons almost had it going the other way, but did go out of bounds before the Falcons got it back. You know, decades ago when I was playing basketball, the term live ball turnover did not exist. Do you remember that before the last 5 or 10 years?
No, I do not.
It's like, when did that term? It makes sense. You turn it over in the play and you don't have a chance to maybe get it back. Anistel drives that left side, this time cut off though by Carr. He doesn't want to see that happen again. There's a strip by Hughes, but a foul's called.
Yes.
Jack Hughes for the Rams, that is, on the strip. Foul. A little bit of a reach.
Should be the sixth team foul on Glenwood. So one more and the Falcons can be in the bonus here. Sitting at an 18-point deficit at the moment. They just need some good things to happen the next 4 minutes here.
That's right. Gets to the rim, scores off glass, fakes the handoff in the corner to Anistel and drives down the left side and banks it in.
Some might call that a zone read in the football terms.
Yeah, it really
right
was.
There.
10, good thing for a quarterback, 10 points for Wright. Shot missed by Stanislav, but Bloom coming in to clean up the rebound. The Rams retain possession. You hate to see that. You get them to miss and then give them another offensive possession. 5 minutes to go exactly. 16-point Rams lead, 55-39. Falcons have cut it to 14, then it bolts right back up to 20. On guard on the backside, and scoring is Hughes. Jack Hughes for the Rams. He has 7. Gas gets near the free throw line. A little fake up and under move. He's going to shoot and miss, but he's going to be fouled that time by Bloom, I believe. 2 free throws coming. Falcons will be in the bonus from now on. The last 4.5. And free throw missed by Gast. Made a couple a second ago. 18-point Glenwood advantage. Bloom and his 4 fouls are going to take a break. Second free throw is missed by Gast. Still 18-point advantage for the Rams. Jack Eichel set to check back in the game. He was the first sub off the bench for the Falcons tonight. I think it's as early as we've seen Jack in the game this season.
Yeah, he's kind of climbed himself up into the rotation more and more.
Jump shot from the free throw line missed by the Rams. Here come the Falcons. Anastel scoops it off to Wright in the corner. He's going to try a 3, gets it to go. Lance Wright leading the Falcons in scoring tonight with 13. That's his 3rd 3-pointer of the game. Dribbling through the Ram defense is Hughes. Gets it stripped. The 2-on-1 Falcon break. We'll see if they can get this one to score. They cannot get it to go with the glass.
They're going to get an opportunity. The ball's going to stay on their end here.
Eichel checks in the game. Spencer, have we talked about all our sponsors? Have I hit them all? Okay, we're good. Making sure we thank the folks. If you look on the website, see who sponsors St. Albert Sports Fan, who sponsors these broadcasts. Patronize their business and tell them you heard it on Sports Fan. Rallis eventually comes up with it. Anastel's going to step into a 3. It's going to be a little bit short. Rams are coming the other way. Eichel and Anastel back on D. 3.5 to go. Uh-oh. Falcons again lose track of Hughes. Let him get right to the rim.
Just not communicating well on the defensive side of the ball here. It's
Falcons turn it over. Rams coming the other way. There's going to be a foul on Anastel. That is only the 15th foul on the Falcons. 59-42, 17-point Falcon advantage. 3 new Falcons, 3 different Falcons set to check back in. Wright, Jeff Miller, and Cy Patterson checking in for Cherney, Gast, and Anastel.
Seeing some different lineup combinations out on the floor for the Falcons tonight. And they've had a tough stretch of ball games, and hopefully get back into conference games next week. I think they go down to Shenandoah on Tuesday. Hopefully have some good things happen to them down there.
Working with the basketball on the left side, missing the shot. They're put back in the lane, scored by Carr. Carr now has 5. 19-point advantage, 61-42. Right with the basketball. Ryan Jenner is going to check back in next dead ball, which is now because the Falcons had a miscommunication turnover.
Yeah, just kids not looking.
Jenner is going to come in for Rallis. His day likely done. Just under 3 minutes to go in the game.
And to see kind of the frustration on the Falcons just right at the moment here. The tough stretch just kind of wore on the kids, and their confidence is not at a high level at the moment. They need some good things to happen. Still no excuse for miscommunication and effort stuff. So the boys need to regroup here.
Sam Narmi also said to check back in. Next dead ball. Eichel to Wright. He's going to try a 3. Gets his feet set. Rattles around. Won't go. Rebound for Justin Giambolva. Alvo, let me read that the right way. New guy checking the game for the Rams anyway. Jeff Miller scores inside.
Nice little push up the floor there by Eichel. Draw the defense and find the open man down on the box there.
Jeff's first 2. Scoring Stanislav. Well, I see in part how Stanislav averages 24 a game, because you leave him in garbage time, and that's going to happen.
Ryan Jenner with the ball up top, passes it off to Eichel. screen set by Patterson. Eichel gets into the lane. He's found Jeff Miller two times in a row there for nice finishes.
Yeah. Now about Falcons, or the Rams come with the rest of their guys. Van Ness drives along the baseline and scores. And as we talked about in the girls' game, Barney Johnson is notorious for calling a timeout and just for a substitution, letting the guys in. On me, the referee says.
Barney, a longtime official here for multiple sports, and does a nice job. And
has the kids' best interest in mind. There's no question. Clock has stopped with 1:10 to go, even though we're playing.
We need that clock guy.
Now 109, hey. But we score now. That's okay. The clock is running after we scored.
That's how the comeback starts right there, Matt.
That probably evened out.
How did the Falcons score 20 points and no time went off the clock?
It kind of evened out. Jeff Miller, though, with three straight baskets. And now gets the free throw. Has 7 points. Eichelt out. His game likely done. 103 to go. 67-49. Falcons going to drop this one to Glenwood. Second time this season. A good Glenwood team, no doubt about that. Glenwood has some interesting games coming up. On the 21st of January, they play Roncalli. And the 25th, they play Scutt.
Yes, both two very good basketball teams. Both highly ranked, I think, in
Class B. In Nebraska. I saw the Roncalli did beat Scutt last Friday.
Did you see a score last night? I think Roncalli was supposed to play Mount Michael last night, and I went to find the paper at work today, and I never did find the paper. I was kind of curious at looking at that score, and that game could have very well been tonight, too. Yeah. I'm not sure what night it was, but I knew that they had each other coming up.
Yeah, I don't have a score on that. I know they had it in Mount Michael's playing Boys Town pretty soon after that, too.
Yeah, I was talking with Lance. He really thought that Roncalli is the best team that they've faced so far this year. He was just really impressed with what they had to bring.
Sam Narmi picks up the foul with 38 seconds to go. Going to send Justin Giambalvo to the free throw line. He misses that. Start doing some scoring summaries here. If something happens here, just add that mentally to your totals. Leading scorer in the game is Christian Stanislav with 24 for the Rams. No one else in double figures. Blum with 9. And now Giambalvo with another one. Jack Hughes with 9. LaPala with 7. Leith with 5. Carr with 7. 6 for Van Ness. Falcons go this way. Lance Wright led him in scoring with 16. There's Jeff Miller, who's come on of late here. 13 for Lance Wright, as I said. 7 for Connor Cherney. 7 for Jeff Miller. Rollis with 4. Aiden Anistel with 4. Jack Eicholt with 3. Jared Gass with 6. And 5 for big man Reed Miller.
There's Jeff Miller getting to the rim again there on a inbounds play. Jeff finishing this game with a little bit of confidence, which would be a good thing for the Falcons going forward. Jeff's a very talented basketball player, and just like to see him get some confidence underneath of him and do some good things on the floor.
Just a sophomore, so we want to thank our score man extraordinaire, Sawyer Sheffield. Miller gets that free throw to go.
And I still think he got paid in Twizzlers.
He gets paid in Twizzlers.
We're talking to Spencer about that.
We got to talk. I want a new deal. Second free throw is good by Miller.
A family pack of Twizzlers goes a long way.
Our loyalty can be bought is all we're saying. So, anyway, Scott Wright on the call with me for both games. Thanks, Scott. So, we're just going to sign off pretty much right after. These doubleheaders are fun, but we're ready to head on for home. Ball poked out of bounds by Anisdell. Clock now down to 16 seconds. Falcons trailing by 17. So full court pressure for St. Albert. Ball nearly stolen away. Anisdell's tracking it down. Sam Narmi helps him steal it, but Narmi with it. Jenneru. Patterson's going to try a three.
And Cy Patterson drills the three.
Gets in the scorebook, so we'll update that score. 3 for Patterson. The final, 68-54. Glenwood wins this one. So, Scott, I appreciate your help.
Thank you for asking. Thanks, Spencer, for putting this on for us. It's an honor to to be on and support the Saints and the Falcons.
Yeah. And, hey, speaking of supporting the Saints and Falcons, come out to the tomorrow night to the auction event downtown. And then Tuesday, either go to Shenandoah or go up to the Palace to watch the game. So for all this crew, this is Matt saying good night and thanks.